What's going on, guys? My name is Toso, and today I'm here to talk about a very, very, very interesting and innovative series. I am here to talk about Scott Pilgrim Takes Off. Now, if you know anything about me, and in case you don't know, Scott Pilgrim vs. the World is easily top three one of my favorite movies of all time. It is hilarious. It's action-packed. I love all of the characters that are in there. There are certain lines that I can't live without, you cocky cock. I love the hell out of that movie, and Edgar Wright most definitely did right with that film. So now we are with the latest entry from the Scott Pilgrim franchise, and I gotta say, when I was watching this series, you know, I was very interested on what direction they were gonna take. They easily could have played the safe route with just adapting the film into an animated series, which me, of course, I would have never minded. Because I'm an anime head at heart at the end of the day. This is stuff I grew up with. These are things I harshly critique, you know? And the animation, let me go ahead and say this really quick, is great. I love the interesting style, you know? It's very consistent with how it was in the comic books, if I'm not mistaken. I think they did a great job animation-wise, right? But let's just go ahead and talk about the series overall. You know, when it first got announced, of course I was hyped. I was like, you know, oh my gosh, the Scott Pilgrim anime, it's gonna be crazy, it's gonna be wild, da 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 da. You know, so I was I was highly anticipating this series to come out before the year, you know, ended, because we in November now. We 2023 is literally almost over, right? So when I finished it yesterday. I just binged the 8 episodes that they had, and to my surprise, and this is I'm you know what, matter of fact, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna keep it spoiler free for right now, and I'm gonna jump into spoilers in a second, okay? So overall, I had fun with the show. I think the show is very, 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 very fun. I think it does a good job expanding on a lot of characters that did not get enough attention from the film itself. Because you have to think, the film was only like an hour and a half, if I'm not mistaken, or a little bit over. So a lot of the villains that show up, a lot of the evil exes, they're literally only there on screen at the most 10, 15 minutes. And then they're out. And that is not even taken into account in the beginning of the movie with setting everything up, right? So that means you don't have a whole lot of time to flesh out these exes at all, right? So the series really jumps on that. It expands on a lot of the characters. It expands on even the characters we follow, Scott, Ramona, Knives even. You know, everybody starts to get a lot more attention. It's very, very fun. There are issues with it, I feel like in regards to the series, I don't think it was, I don't want to say necessary, but the way it feels watching this show, it really feels like one of those holiday specials that kind of shows up and then it's in and then it's out. And I felt like the show, because it becomes a bit of a mystery. I'm going to say that much for right now. It becomes a bit of a mystery. And when it gets to towards the end and you start to figure out what's really going on, I wasn't exactly ecstatic about the big reveal. I thought it was a little, we could have got something else, but it was all good. It was all good, because at the end of the day, I still had a great time watching the show. And that could be the bias or the nostalgia or whatever, because I watched Scott Pilgrim when I was like 9 years old, so I watched it when I was a kid. So it could be that, but I don't know. Part of me didn't necessarily love the big reveal. I do love the message that they had towards the end for one of the characters, but in regards to who was kind of behind pulling the strings, it was like it got a reveal and then it was another reveal on top of the reveal, and it was like, I can't. Okay, now we literally OD'ing with it. So overall, series was fun. I had a great time watching it. I was literally, like, one of my favorite characters is easily Lucas Lee, from the movie. I think Chris Evans does a great job, and in the animation, he's the best idiot. He's the best idiot ever. So, jumping into the premise of the story, you know, I'm going to give you guys a second to dip out in case you need to, in case you haven't watched it. So, the premise of the story is that Scott, you know, the first episode kind of runs down like how the movie does. Scott has a dream about Ramona. He's dating Knives. He's in this band. Blah, 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 blah. Goes to a party, meets Ramona. Y'all already know the story. And then towards the end of the first episode, they put a twist on it where Matthew Patel actually, quote unquote, kills Scott. You know, he actually, Scott loses his first fight. Scott loses and he's completely gone. He's vanished. And that's the mystery, because we're under the impression that Scott's dead, but then you jump into the series and you find out that he's not dead. A portal showed up and he completely just disappeared. And so Ramona, each episode is finding a different ex and trying to figure out exactly what is going on. How do we find Scott? The whole nine yards. So I thought that was very interesting. I think that was a pretty interesting choice, and I wasn't mad at it whatsoever, because out of anybody, Ramona's really cool as a character, and I definitely wanted to know more about her. And even in the movie towards the end, she still is a bit of a mystery, so you learn a lot about her as a person. And she kind of runs away from emotional or distressful situations. She completely avoids them, and she moves on to the next, from one ex to the next, or one city to the next, right? That's kind of been her character. Towards the end of the show, she starts to really, instead of running away, she embraces who she is. And it's really nice. It's a nice little message and a nice little story for her. So the story itself is pretty cool. You know, I like that Scott isn't necessarily the focus. He is, but he isn't at the same time. I do like that even the title itself literally tells you what's going on. Scott takes off. he's just not really in the show. So it's fine. It's fine. I really don't have a whole lot to necessarily say, aside from the fact that overall the series was very enjoyable. You know, I really feel like it was like a love letter almost to the fans that were, you know, fans of either the comic book, the game, or the movie. You know, that this show was definitely just a love letter to everybody, you know. And I thoroughly enjoyed myself. It wasn't the most perfect show in the world, but I did not hate it. The show was really focusing on a lot of lovey-dovey relationships. There was a lot of characters literally just falling in love left and right. It was very interesting, because it was not necessarily what I expected. And I think it's because of the fact that, you know, Scott, he didn't go on the destined journey of fighting the seven evil exes. So a lot of the villains and a lot of the characters, a lot of the villains and a lot of the characters kind of went about their way doing the most random, normal things for the most part, auditioning for movies, maybe singing, playing out a show, working at a coffee shop. They were just doing normal things for the most part, and Ramona was the main one kind of driving the plot to figure out what the fuck is going on. But I did not hate the series at all. I thought it was a pretty good time. I think it was a great time. I don't think we would ever need a second season for it. You can just keep the first season and leave it be. If they ever do a second season, I'm not gonna watch it, because it's pointless. But overall, love the show. If I was to put it on a scale from 1 to 10, I'd give it a seven. I had a lot of laughs. Animation was on point whenever it needed to be, which was majority of the time. Lucas Lee was easily my favorite character. Yeah, 7 out of 10. Very enjoyable. I would recommend you guys to definitely go ahead and check that out whenever you get the time. I also want to thank you guys so much for watching my videos. We hit 400 subscribers, ladies and gentlemen. Clap it up for yourselves. Y'all are incredible. I know for a lot of people, he's celebrating 400 subscribers. You're damn right, bitch. We celebrate all milestones. I celebrate every subscriber that subscribes to my channel. You guys are great. You guys are amazing. I love you guys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.